That takes us right up to lunchtime. There's a round of applause for the church ladies. We're going to start, that's quite a mic. We're going to start with the evening program, and we have folks, I'm sure, who probably had other things to do this evening. We had a very good audience this afternoon, and we've had some real musical treats, including a couple of numbers by Ellis Anderson, one of our founders of Ragtime and Ramble. Ellis said bedtime and Ramble. And speaking of bedtime, now, in the last segment, we're going to hear Brian and Rod Wyanson, and in the earlier segment, right after now, at the luncheon, which is right now, the beginning of the second segment, we have Rod and his lovely wife, Trisha, who plays a hot flute. So we have a lot of treats for you tonight, too. And we thought that probably after such a nice little luncheon with all the desserts and great sandwiches, and whatever, that fruit salad was terrific. And we thought we'd give you some mild-mannered, soft, relaxing music. So, Rod, take it away.
There it is.
Thank you.
It's called the Ash Hogan Farewell. Any of you heard the Civil War Ken Burns broadcast? This was actually written not back in the mid-1800s, much later, but sounds like probably long back then. So this is it, the Ash Hogan Farewell from the Civil War broadcast.
Thank you.
bring up Ryan now again and listen to some more great renditions of his compositions and et cetera. Here we come.
Jello salad, like I am. We can start again. Well, I'll get to right back into it with another composition of Trevor Tichenor, the St. Louis folk ragtime composer I talked about this afternoon. Another of his great folk ragtime kind of all aspects of Americana put together. This is called It's a Long Way Back Home.
Thank you.
You heard a little bit this afternoon about Man Bostic from California, who was the one that wrote Ragtime and Randall Rag. And she made many Ragtime Festival appearances because she was the grandniece of Charles Daniels, who was a very noted composer, publisher, and arranger of Ragtime in the Ragtime era. So there's that kind of direct connection right to the Ragtime era. And so here's a piece that is by a woman composer, and one that would have been, it was published by Charles Daniels. This was written by someone named Grace Marie Bolin, I think it was 1901, and I think she wrote it at a very early age, like still a teenager. So here is Grace Bolin's 1901 composition, The Smoky Topaz. Thank you. a really special moment now because I'm going to play one of my own compositions and probably by far the most recent composition of mine that I'll be playing here tonight. And this was a special commission for a certain couple. This was for the 40th anniversary of this couple right here, the Holmeses, Bob and Joni. And it was for their 40th anniversary gala, a little 3-4 time piece in a contemporary style, I guess. And this is called Kissed Under the Rainbow Moon. So this is a piece that 1990, Oleg Mensurev, Swedish composer, this is dedicated to the heroic musicians of the Titanic. And so this is called Café Parisien.
Thank you. Now, when Kay and I moved to Ames, we didn't know about Ragtime. That was 1972. This wouldn't be happening if it wasn't for Bob McNutt. Because, as I heard the story, he was a piano tuner. He had clients in Des Moines. He had clients in Twin Cities. And he looked around and found a nice house in Randall and said, well, that's pretty close to maybe halfway. And so he bought the house. And he was a very friendly guy and he started having people over to his house to play the piano. And it grew into a festival. And he attracted the attention of people like Alice Anderson, Bob Lee, Joyce. What's Joyce's last name?
Lewis.
Lewis, Joyce Lewis, and others. And it became a wonderful annual tradition. Then we had our 25th anniversary, and we were never on the committee. But it closed up there. Everybody celebrated 25 wonderful years. The reason we still have Ragtime in Randall, I believe, is due to just one person, and that would be Don Brecky. So let's give it up for Don Brecky. Thank you, Don. So, I guess I can start the next stage. Don doesn't want it. We're going to pass the collection by again. If there's anybody in here that wants to be a benefactor, that would be $1,000 or more. But, you know, whatever change you have or whatever bills you have that you feel are appropriate to help this committee. And I'm not on the committee, but I really admire the people that are on the committee. It's called the Randall Area. The area is a very important word. Randall Area Fine Arts Council.
Sunny Stumps by Jelly Roll Morton. I don't think any Jelly Roll's been done, so I thought that would be a good one to throw in here. So, do you want any more?
Wait, I want to play one more.
All right, okay, all right. I don't know any more. Well, I better have my wife put her flute away, but, you know, any desire there? Well, Brian's coming up here shortly. I tell you what, here's what I'll do. I'm going to do the Sidewalk Blues, also by Morton, all right? The Sidewalk Blues, if you ever heard of it.
Is there a vocal on that?
There's a little bit of shouting toward the end, but I'm not sure I have all the words on that, all right?
Dear composition, Ragtime and Randall Reich. wrote that piece had a lot of programmatic or thematic elements in it, like certain sections and their feelings represented certain people, like there was a certain one section piece with Bob Lean in mind and so forth. Also, that very ending of the piece where it kind of just fades away into nothing, I think was supposed to represent after Nan has been here in Iowa and then she's gotten on the plane back to California and kind of up into the horizon. That's kind of what that represents. I know there's a lot more, and the one I remember that just occurred to me again today was the very opening of the piece, the start of the melody. That was actually intentional as kind of an Iowa reference. These notes consciously quote 76 trombones. Oh. And that's why the piece starts like that. I will move next to, one more Trevor Tischer composition. This is again early 1960s Midwestern folk ragtime. And this was published in the book They All Played Ragtime. So here is also from my CD traditions. This is called Chestnut Valley Rag. Visit a composer I talked about this afternoon, and a real favorite of mine that I've gotten to know over the internet named Brandon Byrne from Michigan. He's a 20-year-old composer and writing some really strikingly fine, effective, expressive ragtime currently. And here's another one of his pieces, again very lyrical, introspective, with some, I think, a little bit of pop elements too in the melody writing. So. Music of Brandon Byrne from Michigan. This is called The Lighthouse.
Thank you.
Thank you. Well, in the 1970s, with the popularity, of course, of the movie The Sting, real revitalization in the awareness and popularity of Scott Joplin's music, and even more great new ragtime that was being written then. So this is a piece from about that era, I think from 1975 or 79. The composer is named William Ryden, who was a New York-based composer, very prolific in ragtime and neoclassical work. I don't know if he's still active, I've never seen him perform, but this is perhaps one of his best ones. Kind of really goes beyond the boundaries of ragtime. I think I would call this more of a romantic essay with some syncopation. The music of William Ryden, this is called Sadly, Sadly, Little Rag.
Thank you.
played one of my own compositions in this set yet, so here's a another reg of mine written about 1991 or 92, and another example of how the sometimes strange or random ways pieces get their titles. This one is very similar in origin to the famous piece of the ragtime era, Dill Pickles by Charles Johnson, just because he was in the back of a warehouse or something and somebody was walking by with a box of jars of Dill Pickles, and so that's how he named it, because he just thought that was as good a name as any. Same with this one. My first job in high school and first summer of college was Frank's Nursery in Crafts. And again, kind of same story, bags of grass seed in the bag. Kentucky bluegrass in this case, they just said Kentucky blue on the package, so that sometimes it, things just stand out as something that would be a good name for a piece. So, never been to Kentucky, but this is called Kentucky Blue.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. I have one more tune to do before going back to Rod and have some fun sing-along time. But thank you again for having me. It's always something I would never miss to come to Right Time in Randall. And as tradition has it, must end the set with Maple Leaf Rag, Scott Joplin 1899, was when it was published. And Scott Joplin's first real big hit in the publishing world that was the real symbol of ragtime becoming the popular music in America. So here's Maple Leaf Rag one more time.
Yeah.
I thought too, a good ragtime song, I usually do it two speeds, fast and faster. But I thought maybe I might slow down a little bit for singing purposes. And I'll start with a verse, and I don't know the words of the verse quite well enough, but it was written in 1914. And some of you will probably recognize it. And join me when I get to that part of the song. Here we go.
Maybe.
be you.
Sing-along, I've been choosing too darn many of myself, I just got to realize them, so let me have it here. I know, Richard, you're not shy, what do you got? He's trying to sell me a car, I can tell that.
This is in memory of one of your favorite fans.
Alright. Richard and his wife tragically lost their son in a real tragic accident, on a four-wheeler or something, 6 years ago. And they've asked me to play Pat Swaller, Your Feet's Too Big. I will be glad to do that. Man, that's tough. It's hard to believe it's been 6 years already. How old was he?
17.
So what a tough thing to have to deal with. But we're gonna make everyone smile hopefully a little bit here. Here we go. Your feet's too big. Here we go.
Thank you.
It was a pretty funny song back there in about 29 when that was written. Your feet's too big. So, okay, we have about time for about three more. I don't want to hold anyone here too long, but I want you to make sure you get your money's worth for you donators. So anything come to your fancy for
I got
request.
Rhythm.
What?
Who's I that? Got rhythm.
I got rhythm? I'll be glad to. This won't be an instrumental. Like, I think I don't know that I know the words quite well all the way through. But you will all be encouraged to sing. Something to do, all of you know it. I think you will all know it. And I kind of changed the meter a little bit.
Meter is how many beats per measure, not that it matters, but I think you'll know it very, very well. It's something you often sing in church.
Something that absolutely all of you will know that hasn't been repeated. Here we go.
You know what I'd like to hear?
What's that?
Fred Waring in Pennsylvania.
Oh. The whole orchestra. I think I'm going to have a hard time doing taking care of that one. But I remember Little Orly and all those Little Orly records. Don is one of the few people I know that knows what I've been talking about. It was very human interest. Richard knows. Great stuff. By the way, it's all available on CDs. If you, you know, those old scratchy 78s that you can hardly hear anything on, it was very good moral of the story of just life in general, but done through a children's interest, so you've not heard of it. But here's the song I think we'll end the evening with.
Hey, Rod.
What?
Can you tell them that this will be on YouTube tomorrow? Jazz Band Joe 100.
Jazz Band Joe 100, it will be on YouTube tomorrow. That will be October 23rd, 2016. All right? Here we go. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy.
Thank you, everyone. Don, do you have any parting comments?
You have to get your mic here.
Okay. I want to thank you and Brian and Tricia and everyone here for coming. And I think we took in enough today to have another show next fall. And so from all of us on the RayFac, Ragtime and Randall faction, thanks a lot. Appreciate it.
Is it always the same weekend?
No.
Oh, okay.
It used to be the first weekend in October, and then it went to the second.